Ryan here today. I'm back with what's going to be my first installment of my new series called Game Talk. But before we get into that, remember to leave a like on the video. Today, I will be reviewing Assassin's Creed Black Flag. Assassin's Creed Black Flag is the sixth major installment of Ubisoft's Assassin's Creed franchise. The setting is in 18th century Caribbean, which is also known as Golden Age of Pirating. The main character of the game is Edward Kenway, a notorious pirate who we will follow along in his path for redemption. Overall, there's so much to say about what I like and dislike about the game. One major thing is, unlike the other Assassin's Creed story, you're placed directly into the action when you're on a burning ship. It also has great graphics, a very large open world setting of the Caribbean. You don't have to follow a guided path. Right off the bat, you have a lot of free will to go and do what you want. A relatively easy combat system compared to the other games. I really enjoyed this factor, and the large variety of weapons really hammers the game down. Side quests make up a large portion of the game, and if I were you, I would not skip these. They bring a lot of fun and adventure to the game. And last of all, a ship. Yes, you heard me, a ship. Which can be upgraded. It's called the Jackdaw, and it is actually your main use of transportation. This is what you will be using to get around the Caribbean, and honestly, the game would not be the same without it, obviously. It's just such a good factor, and there's so much combat that goes with that ship. I believe this is one of the, you know, best things about the game. Every great game has its downfalls. This game isn't excluded. A lot of these are kind of preference based, but something I think we can all agree on are certain annoyances like disappearing bodies, which will actually cause you to have to restart missions, and wrong commands causing Edward to jump off of buildings when you don't want to. Other things, personally for me, I really didn't enjoy anything outside the Animus. That's just always kind of been me. I like to be in the action. So that story outside, while kind of interesting, really just didn't get my attention too well. Finally, I'm gonna have to say the main story is kind of a bit of a letdown, but this is backed up due to the side quests and just the overall overall adventure of the main story. It's time for the ratings. This will go in this order: graphics, cinematics, content, controls, gameplay, story, and music. These are all basically the key essential parts of a game. So starting off, graphics. I'm really gonna have to rate this one pretty high, at 8 out of 10. Now, this is probably one of the better looking Assassin's Creed games in the franchise, and honestly, I love the overall look and cinematics of the game. There we will go into the next, cinematics. I gave these 7 out of 10. Not because of the looks, just because of sometimes they can be pretty boring. And most are skippable, so I'm pretty happy about that. Next is the content. Overall, I gave this a 9 out of 10 because, you know, the content of the game I loved. It just has so much in store. Controls, this will kind of vary based on what you played on. I played it on my Xbox, so I really never had a problem with it, and they were quite simple, but for PC, these could be a bit lower, and they may be harder to get down. Gameplay, I personally gave it a 9 out of 10. This is because I just had so much fun playing this game, and I was able to actually play it just through completion, which I usually can't do with a lot of games. Next up, we have story. I gave that a 5.5 out of 10. The story really just could have been pat down better. We are looking at somebody who kind of lost his wife. Didn't lose her in the sense of dying, but has lost her. Really, the story could have just been so much better, and it had so much potential, you know, with the setting and all. The final rating we'll be getting into is the music, which overall really adds to the ambience and atmosphere of the game, and it's really just piratey, and I really love it a lot. It was directed by Brian Tyler, and I'm gonna have to give this one an 8 out of 10, so For the overall reading of the game, I'm going to have to put it at 9 out of 10. Black Flag turns out to be an astounding game, with beautiful scenery, easy-to-use combat controls, and overall, its amazing sense of adventure makes it my favorite Assassin's Creed by far. So, that's going to wrap up today's video, guys. Remember to subscribe and hit the bell to be the first to know when I upload new videos. Also, don't forget to leave a comment suggesting any future video ideas you might have, or just leave your thoughts. My name's Ryan, and I'll see you in the next video.